These are beef short ribs, and there's basically 5 to 6 bones across there. And as the short rib cooks, it sticks to that bone. The bone implants flavour, and the meat just sort of melts. Cooked slowly, gives it that nice level of intensity. Slice alongside the bone, straight down. You can see that marbling? That sort of disappears and disintegrates.
I'm cooking them in a roasting tray. Get it on the heat until nice and hot.
Season the beef short ribs beautifully. Olive oil in, bone on the top. We'll start colouring that in. Really important to give the beef short ribs a really nice sear. If you didn't brown the meat off, it goes in the oven and it looks like boiled meat. So you really want that nice, dark, rich colouring. Just cut the garlic in half, slide that down the side. That's going to give that beef an amazing flavour.
To give body to the sauce, stir in a heaped teaspoon of tomato puree.
So I'm just hitting the bottom of the pan with that tomato puree. And we call it cooking out the tomato puree. Otherwise, it just goes in there raw, and it gives this sort of tartness to the braised short ribs. Red wine in. Don't use an expensive bottle of red wine. There's no need.
Bring the wine up to the boil and reduce it. This burns off the alcohol and concentrates the flavour.
It makes a big difference when you reduce the red wine down by half because it gives that nice, dark, rich intensity. Look at my garlic. That is just going to sweeten everything up. Incredible. Stock in. Beef stock, perfect. Chicken stock, fine. Just to about an inch underneath the beef short ribs. Bring it up to the boil.
To lock in all that flavour as the beef ribs slow cook, cover them so they braise from the bottom and steam from the top.
Into the oven, 2.5 hours. 170 to 180 degrees. In she goes.
The great thing about slow cooking is you do most of the work in advance and then put your feet up.
5 or 10 minutes before the beef short ribs come out of the oven, start your garnish. This is light cured pancetta. I want nice, thick lardons, nice, big, thick sticks of crispy bacon. These are delicious chestnut mushrooms. I'm not going to slice them. I'm just going to cut them in half. But look at the colour on those lardons now. All the white, raw fat has disappeared. The lardons have shrunk right down. And all we've got there now is the proper bacon. Mushrooms in. Beautiful. So the mushrooms get seasoned from the bacon.
I'm pan frying these separately to the beef so they remain crisp and add a different texture.
Leave that to cool down. Now, this is like Christmas Day for me. When you unwrap that foil, wait to see what's underneath it. Wow. They smell incredible. Lift and place on your tray. Beautiful.
To make a fantastic, rich, deep sauce, press the soft roasted garlic through a sieve into the cooking juices.
Want all that nice pureed garlic coming through there. Because that is going to make the most amazing flavour. Scrape all of that off the sieve. Nice. And then just start sieving all that lovely braising liquor. Whoa. In. That smells delicious. Take your sauce and just glaze. Do them individually. They deserve that respect. Spoon on your bacon and your mushrooms. Beautiful. Be generous with these mushrooms. I'm telling you, they taste amazing. Flat leaf parsley. All that freshness over those amazing ribs. Incredible. Never ever be embarrassed about going to your butcher and asking for cheap cuts because the results are incredible. Amazing beef braised short ribs with bacon and mushrooms. Pour in